We're about to hit the road. There's the pack. We're about to head out. It's about 7:45 a.m. Hopefully, about 18 miles. Hopefully that's like all it is. Okay, so I've only gone about a mile, but this sign came up. It says Sespe Hot Springs only 15 miles away, so that's good news if that's really the case. It's about 8:15, and the trail seems good. There's a lot of water in the river, so hopefully that'll continue. And it's pretty cold out right now. It's probably below 60 degrees, just because I'm wearing short sleeves and shorts, but I'm sure I'm gonna try to appreciate this well. So there's Piedra Blanca, I think, because it's white. Pretty cool. One of the best campsites here, probably in Southern California. Nobody's there, and the river is, it's got quite a bit of water, so that's cool. Well, maybe there is somebody down there. Maybe there is somebody down there, yeah. But I'll tell you what, this is the first person that I've seen on this entire trek so far. I'm running into my first set of campers. I don't know if you can see the smoke coming up from down there. Let's see. Yeah. And it's actually a pretty awesome little site that they have. Anyway, about close to 5 miles in. So this is an actual stream crossing, and unfortunately, I have gotten wet. This river is usually not this high right here. So about 5.5 miles in, and the trail is just getting absolutely beautiful. Look at that tree out there. It's really cool. It's rolling hills. If you can see, but there's a huge hawk circling over there. So we gotta go up that hill. So we're about 8 miles in. This was just a really cool area, just flat, and then across this gorge, there's just this awesome field, which kind of makes me want to camp there next time. But there's also kind of cool campsite down there, and then you've got kind of like this canyon wall down there giving you shade. So it's, we're getting into some really amazing views out here. I'm almost 10 miles in, and it's a totally different environment now. I mean, it's pretty like wooded. You can hear a river over that way, and I'm hoping that I'm gonna be hitting up Willet Springs soon. So I've kind of lost the trail, but I think across the river, it looks like it picks up again. Unfortunately, there's pretty nasty water crossing that I'm most likely gonna get wet on, but I'll try to get through it here. I mean, some of these it just kind of looks like you gotta pick your poison here. That does look like a trail, obviously, so that's the good news. The only problem is I'm gonna get wet, so. If I can make it over there. So I was able to pick up the trail again, and it's pretty cool. At like 10.63 miles, there's just probably one of the most beautiful campsites I've ever seen. So I just came across this, which that in addition to the sound of running water, I feel like maybe this is Willett, Willett Hot Springs. So check back if it is. So we're stopping for lunch. This foot doesn't look that bad, but on this foot, we got a flapper. Well, I finished lunch and I checked on my feet and I have a pretty bad hot spot under my heel on my right foot, and it's also tender behind the heel. And then I've got that flapper on the left, on the back of my left heel. But if my calculations are correct, hopefully I only have 6 miles to go. So I can't wait to put on those camp booties and just veg out and basically just, it's kinda suck that I have to cut firewood when I get there, but all right. I'll tell you what, these river crossings are getting a little annoying right now, especially since I just dressed my foot. My energy level is actually fine. It's just my foot basically feels like I'm getting an Indian burn like on my heel every time I take a step. So this wet sock, since I just changed out my socks, that was a waste of time. The trail is getting super scarce or hard to follow at this point. I'm still at only like 12 and a half miles, but thank God people are leaving a few little markers here and there, whether it's like trail tape or the little stone pile. So let's see if you can see it. Like, that's basically the only markers for the trail. Just pooped. Just got out of a lot of brush, and the trail is continually in and out as far as being able to follow it, but you know, obviously I'm on it now. There's the river over there. It's really pretty out here. Somehow, you know, I guess I missed Willett Springs. I don't really know what the deal is with that. Maybe I'll see it tomorrow on my way back, but I'm about 13 and a half miles out. So at this point, there's really no one that I've seen. I haven't seen anybody in the last like 2 hours, basically. That's all for now. Check this guy out. Okay, so I basically, The river split, but the only trail that I could really see was going north, and I believe that I need to go north at some point and break off to hit the hot springs. So I'm just gonna kind of trust the trail, and I'm about 14 and a half miles in. So since I don't know exactly how long I'm going, I'll just have to trust the trail. Although this is kind of cool. Old. Just passed mile 15. And I gotta say, it was getting a little scary because it's a lot more narrow back here and I'm just, feels super remote, but just found a campsite, so it's like, there are signs of life, and the trail continues. There's some sort of sign up there. Okay, so that sign was for, I think it's like pronounced Mutau Flats, but I think that's another way to get in to, like, I remember reading that you can come down that way, and it's shorter, but most people don't want to do it because it's like straight up to go up. So I took this little trail to the right, and that's this trail right now.
And I remember in the videos for Sespe that it said that, well, it showed that there were palm trees out there, like little mini oases. So there is a campsite right there. Not very good wind cover, but obviously we've got some palm trees. So I don't know if this is it. If it is, then it's a lot closer than what I thought. Got a little prickly pears right there. I mean, this is definitely the kind of makeshift oasis that I saw online, so I'm just not sure where the actual hot springs are. Yeah, so I just touched the water and it's really, really hot. So these are the hot springs. I'm gonna hike up a little bit further just to check them out, but we're shy of 16 miles, so that's a welcome change, but I'm gonna hike up a little bit further, see if there's any better little pools. So I guess this whole area is basically the hot springs, because all of this is really hot water, and there seems to be a source over there, like a waterfall of it, so I'm gonna go check that out. But it certainly smells like hot springs, smells like sulfur. So yeah, this water is, I mean, it's basically too hot to touch. So I'm gonna go further down, and it looks like there's another source right there, that waterfall. So this is basically like the top of it. I don't know if you can actually see the, whew, it's really sulfury. See that steam coming off. It's really freaking hot. Oh look, there's kind of the source. I am at the hot springs. It's on the verge of being uncomfortably hot, but I'll tell you what, sticking my feet in there, whew, it's really great. Now I'm contemplating on whether I should camp right here on this mound, or if I should go down to where there's colder water. Here's where I'm going to be camping. There's actually the hot springs is so hot that it runs along this stream, so I'll be able to just go down there and just check it out and hang out. There's actually another group of campers, so I feel a little bit better about that. And so we found the springs, and it's right down that way, but they're too hot to put your feet in, so I'm gonna do it down here. Oh, not gonna lie, this is pretty nice. Check out the steam coming off the water. I got my whiskey, and I'm gonna do some laundry and watch a movie, eat some dinner, and call it a day. All right, so I got the camp all set up. I'm gonna have some dinner, watch a movie, call it a day. Just chilling, watching radio over. And by watching, I mean watching Caveman Tech TV.
So my little alcohol stove seems to be working really well, and it's a beautiful morning here. And we made it through without getting killed by mountain lions or bears. And my food was intact. So, pretty excited. Gonna have some coffee, some breakfast, pack up, and hit home. My legs don't feel that bad, but we'll see how my foot does. We're getting ready to hit the trail. Got a little bit of a later start than I wanted to, but we're all packed up, and let's see if we can get this done in 7 hours.
This is the last we'll see of the hot springs. You can definitely see the steam coming off, so it's pretty hot. Good time.
News is, we found out yesterday that it's really only 16 miles here, so that makes me feel a little bit better.
My energy is not the issue. My legs aren't even sore, really. It's just my left foot. That blister ripped off somehow in the night. So I dressed it and I put some anti-chafing stuff on it and we'll see how it holds up. Right now it doesn't hurt too bad, but 16 miles of this is gonna be a little bit annoying. Open grass. So probably about 14 miles to go, but the view, oh my God, it's amazing. Well, here we got another river I need to cross. This one's pretty big, but I think I can maybe make my way across without getting too wet. About 6 miles away from, I just saw this.
It's like a mule train or something. Pretty cool.
Start another river crossing. Probably gonna stop and get some water, but I'm a little skeeved out because I just passed some other hikers heading out saying that there was a rattlesnake in this area. So hopefully I don't get that on tape.
I'm still at that creek. Had to refill my water. I think I'm about 6 miles until I get back to the car. Again, it's really not the energy. It's both my feet are kind of acting up now. My right foot has a pretty bad hot spot on the bottom of the heel, and then the left foot at the back of the heel, this blister is just out of control.
It's painful. Still got 6 miles.
Rattlesnake encounter was pretty intense, but it gave me some energy, so I'm gonna use it. We're about 5 miles out from the Piedra Blanca trailhead, and I gotta tell you, my feet are torn up. Both of them are pretty rough at this point, but that left heel is—it's not fun.
I came around this last corner and. This is the first time I've been able to see Piedra Blanca in the background, which means we're getting close. Thank the Lord. Oh my God, remember this sign from the beginning? And I think I can see the cars over there. Which means we're basically a half mile away. There's Piedra Blanca. My feet are really not doing well. So I'm excited to get back to the car and sit down and have a cheeseburger.